This video compares the different types of transdermal topical TRT methods. What is the best testosterone cream? We'll have a comparison of topical TRT preparations for testosterone optimization therapy in men. Welcome to my channel.
Who's Dr. Fox?
The lifting dermatologist.
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 The clinical burden of hypogonadism in men has increased notably over the past few years and is associated with a high comorbidity rate, particularly diabetes, metabolic syndrome, cardiovascular diseases, and adverse bone health. There is an array of approved TRTs available, with varying formulations such as injectable products, oral formulations, buccal preparations, and topical gels, solutions, and patches. Transdermal testosterone gel formulations have become a popular TRT option in patients with hypogonadism since their advent in the year 2000. The gel formulations seem to restore testosterone levels to mid-normal physiological levels. Sadly, in many men suffering from low T symptoms, this does not seem to be efficient enough to help alleviate all the signs and symptoms of testosterone deficiency. Although testosterone gels are the ideal option for many that are afraid to inject or that cannot stick to a regular multiple times a week injection schedule, the risk of secondary exposure poses a challenge. Topical TRT options are associated with an increased risk of secondary exposure and may lead to virilization in women and premature puberty in children. Some intramuscular preparations, the pioneers in TRT, may lead to pronounced supraphysiological or fluctuating testosterone levels, especially the short-acting formulations, and injection itself may cause pain and redness at the injection site. Click on this card to watch a video I made on this topic. Approved testosterone topical formulations include Androgel, Testogel, Testim Gel, and many others. These topical testosterone gels are hydroalcoholic topical formulations containing 1-2% of testosterone. Androgel 1% was the first topical gel formulation developed. The starting dose is 5 grams, 50 milligrams testosterone, which could be applied by hand over the shoulders and both arms. As a line extension, it was also approved in the EU as Androgel 1.62% with a starting dose of 2.50 grams, 40.5 milligrams of testosterone, dispensed by two pump activations and applied by hand over both shoulders and upper arms. Testim 1% was the second gel developed as a unit dose of 5 grams tube of 1% strength, containing 50 milligrams of testosterone, applied to the shoulders by hand. Testavan or Testarzon, the new 2% testosterone gel, uses a novel hydroalcoholic and highly viscous topical formulation. The product is homogeneous, transparent and non-staining, and comes in a metered dose dispenser that includes a hands-free cap applicator for precise dispensing and application. The starting dose is 23 mg testosterone delivered by one pump activation, contained in 1.15 grams of gel, and the highest dose is 3.45 grams of gel containing 69 milligrams testosterone, delivered by three pump activations. Compared to the other topical products, the amount of gel used with Testavan is generally less than the other products due to its higher bioavailability, owing to its composition. In a randomized, active-controlled phase 1 study in down-regulated men, Testavan showed higher testosterone bioavailability while delivering more testosterone in a small volume as compared with Androgel. Also, there is no intended secondary exposure to the hands, which minimizes the risk of secondary exposure. And then there is the possibility to have a pharmacy compound, a 200 mg per 1 gram 20% testosterone cream that should be applied to the scrotum twice a day in a dose of 100 to 150 mg testosterone per application. This compounded cream has several major advantages. 1. It seems obvious that the chances of secondary exposure to others are much less because of the site of application. 2. Because of the higher concentration, much smaller amounts of cream are needed, 1.50 to 1.75 grams per application. 3. Pharmacokinetic studies on the absorption of testosterone cream on the scrotal skin show 8 times higher absorption rates than on the shoulders. 4. The cream base is much better tolerated than the hydroalcoholic topical gels regarding skin irritation and discomfort. 5. Twice a day application ensures less fluctuations in the testosterone concentrations in the blood. 6. Higher DHT levels are responsible for libido. 7. More efficient in bringing up the testosterone levels in the high end of the normal range, which is of course better to alleviate all the signs and symptoms of testosterone deficiency. Next, to helping optimize the normal functioning of the male endocrine system, strengthening the bones, being cardioprotective, keeping a high insulin sensitivity, and many more health benefits. We can conclude that the scrotal administration of testosterone in a compounded cream formulation provides higher bioavailability, a dose-dependent peak serum testosterone concentration, and tolerability with a much lower dose relative to the non-scrotal transdermal route. To end this video, I want to thank and give a lot of credit to Dr. Keith Nichols, always being open, helpful, motivational, and helping me out with a lot of information that went into this video. You will see him in a video on my channel in the near future. Thanks again, Keith, for everything. Also, a big shout out to Jay Campbell and his TOT Revolution podcast, spreading the knowledge on TOT around the world. Thank you for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, and please share it among your friends.